Right now we're in the we're in Biloxi, Mississippi, which is basically the center of the Mississippi Gulf Coast. And what we've been dealing with is derelict crab traps, which is a form of marine debris. These fishermen don't want to lose these traps, but it's just part of the fishery. So we go out and we actively remove these traps because these traps are a detriment to the environment.
You know, it saves from crab and fish too by getting them cleaned up. The only thing it would do with crabbing, if the crab, you know, would get into pots and can't get back out, you know, and they'll die.
So the Mississippi Derelict Crab Trap Removal Program is a partnership between the Mississippi Department of Marine Resources, which is the management agency involved, the University of Southern Mississippi's lab, which is the research entity, and then the Mississippi Crab Task Force, which represents the stakeholders within the fishery and the environment as well.
It's been a very successful program and one that has been modeled by other states. Mississippi's removed over 21,000 traps just from our small coastline, and Gulf-wide, over 100,000 traps.
That thing's been going good. You know, we don't have we do it from time to time, and we don't have near the, you know, derelicts like we used to, because they keep them cleaned up pretty good now.
A lot of traps get lost due to extremely high tides, mainly due to storm events. When a storm brings in a really high tide, it can cause the traps to be wrapped up, rolled up, and they'll either be pushed up against the bank or put into deeper water where they'll continue to roll around the bottom. And another way is through theft. That's a big problem that we have. People would pick a trap up, dump the crabs out, and then throw them somewhere else. After that, they do become derelict because the fisherman doesn't know where they're at. And another problem is the ropes that's attached to the float will get cut by vessel propellers, and then once they do that, they immediately become derelict. Not only are they an eyesore, nobody likes to look at derelict crab traps up against a marsh, but they are detrimental to the environment because they continue to fish even though they're not being baited.
When the trap is lost, of course, usually there's still some bait in the trap, and that draws other species. As they stay in the traps, they become bait sometimes themselves.
Continues to fish and continues to kill these animals. Like I said, mainly blue crabs, but a lot of other bycatch species as well. And really, once you have a trap in the environment that is derelict, everything's bycatch.
One of the things that we do is to carefully monitor bycatch because people like to know what's coming up in these in the traps. And when we go out with the commercial fishermen, we record everything that comes up in their trap.
Involving the commercial fishermen is probably the most important part because this is their livelihood. They are the stakeholders. So getting them involved, they give back to what they're taking out.
I would think all of them support it, you know. Even the sports, commercial, they would all.
We're trying to not only protect the fishery, but to protect the environment. So to be able to go out there and remove these traps that are continually ghost fishing, we're benefiting the fishery and the environment.
Congratulations to the Mississippi Department of Marine Resources, the first place winner of the 2017 Gulf Guardian Award in the Partnerships category.